everyone, and welcome to my new Dory Paint video! A couple of weeks ago, I went shopping to one of our local stores, and there I have found on sale, really for probably half price or something like this, this beautiful Moana doll from Hasbro Disney Princess doll collection. I was so happy, I was so excited about it, that of course I've bought it instantly, immediately. Because I think this is really the best doll from the entire Hasbro collection. Because first of all, this doll really looks like the original character, she really looks like Moana. I really adore her body type. Finally, we have a little bit curvy doll. Really amazing. She has these flat feet. And also, what is the most important for me, her body is fully articulated. She has joints in her elbows and she has joints in her knees. But I think I could make her look even better. So, let's open this box, let's remove the outfit and let's start the transformation. Oh, and there is, by the way, another very interesting detail I wanted to mention. If you live in Europe here, the same like me, then you probably know this doll under the name Vaiana. And the rest of the world knows her as Moana. And this is because the word Moana has been already registered as a trademark in Europe. So the creators had to find something else. So they came up with the word Vaiana, because in this language Moana means ocean and Vai means water. So these both names, they mean approximately the same. The ocean girl, the water girl. So it was a moment of science here on my channel. And now let's get back to art. So here is our doll, and her outfit looks terrible, of course, especially the skirt. It's difficult even to imagine something cheaper than this. They have just printed a picture of Moana's skirt onto some very cheap synthetic fabric. They produce probably, I don't know, thousands of these skirts per hour. So let's remove it all, and then I will take the head off. With these Hasbro dolls, you can just pull it off without warming it up, because this anchor inside is very simple and it's not deep at all. Now I can protect her hair, and after this I will remove her face with pure acetone. The next step is sealing her face with 3 layers of this Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then I'm going to draw a new face of our Moana doll. And I'm going to start, like always, with sketching her eyes and eyebrows. Then I can draw the nostrils and the lips. And after this, I contour her face using soft pastels. I drew the eyelids a little bit more detailed with pencils and add a touch of soft pastels on top of it for some smoother blending. I add a touch of blush to her cheeks, then I seal all these powders with another layer of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and after this I can start drawing the white of her eyes, the irises, and then I also draw the eyebrows more detailed. And after this, I can add shadows and highlights to make the face more alive and like three-dimensional. With a very sharp black pencil, I draw the bottom eyelashes and I also add some tiny accents. And after this, I'm going to put the brightest highlights to her eyes using white acrylics. Okay, now I'm going to blush her body as well to make it look the same like the face. And first of all, I want to prepare the surface by removing this glossy top from it using the nail buffers. Then I'm going to clean it with an acetone-free nail polish remover. After this, I will seal it with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear. And after this, I will blush it with the same soft pastels like we've just used for her face. Let's remove the protection from her hair, and you see I can easily remove this Mr. Super Clear from the hairline. I know that many people worry about it really a lot for some reason, but in reality it takes just a minute to remove it. So now I'm going to do some oil on her hair, because now it looks just like some bird nest. After this, I can add glossy acrylic varnish to her eyes and lips, and then we'll move to the outfit and the accessories. I'm going to start probably with her skirt, because it requires quite a lot of work, because in reality this skirt exists out of three parts, not out of one part like this ridiculous skirt from Hasbro, but in reality there is a straw skirt, then on top of it comes a fabric decorated with embroidery, and on top of it comes a red belt. So let's start with the straw skirt probably, and I'm going to use this ribbon for it. I bought it already a while ago to make something like this, and there was lots of these ribbons for sale before Easter in all shops, because it's mostly used for an Easter decoration, I think. And first of all, I'm going to make it completely loose. I will need just these short pieces of this paper straw today. And the next step reminds me very much of making webs for yarn mix. I put these pieces of paper straw on a flat plastic surface and I add a good amount of tacky glue to the one side. I let it dry completely, then I peel it off from the plastic surface, I trim this glued side a little bit, and then I make it more straw looking by covering it with acrylics. And then I glue the straw wafts to a piece of a satin ribbon. So the bottom part of the skirt is finished, and now let's move to the white fabric on top of it, and for this I had to get out all my embroidery materials from a forgotten drawer. But first of all, let's sketch the design on the white fabric using this special marker that can be easily removed with water later. And then I'm just sitting for about 8 hours busy with the embroidery. who finished. I don't know why it takes so long all the time. So now let's cut it out and turn in the sides. I'm going to cut out some parts of this lace and I will attach these pieces to the long sides of our embroidered fabric. After this, I can remove the marker with water, iron the fabric, and the second part of the skirt is also ready. So now I'm going to use this piece of red fabric as a belt. I was thinking for 2 days probably about remaking her top, but I don't really know if I should do it, because I would make just exactly the same top, but out of another fabric. So after a long thinking and looking at this top and at the reference pictures, and after going through all the pieces of fabric that I have here in my studio, I've decided to keep this original top because it looks really close to the one we see in the movie. Now I still want to make a paddle for her using a barbecue stick and epoxy sculpt. And then 24 hours later, when the epoxy sculpt gets completely dry, I decorate it with acrylics. here's my improved version of Moana doll. I think she looks much more advanced than before, and I'm especially happy about this skirt. It really pulls the complete look up. And she also started to look more girlish and more playful, I think, because the original doll seemed a little bit manly for the character. And I also love how different she looks compared to my regular very skinny Monster High and Barbie dolls. I just hoped, guys, I would be able to finish this doll a little bit faster than my other projects and to progress a bit in my work and to have at least some days free, because I didn't have to reroute her hair this time, and she also wears no shoes. But nope, the skirt took me more than 3 days to make, plus the face more than 2 days, plus the paddle a day and a half, plus making the video also 2 days and a half, and it's Friday again. You know, sometimes I think I put too much pressure on myself uploading a doll per week, really every week Friday already for 3 years. But anyway, never mind, I don't want to complain about it. It's my choice and this is my job and this is my dream job. And anyway, everyone has pressure in his work. And mine is for sure not the worst one. I was just really hoping to finish it a little bit faster and to progress a bit. But nope, it didn't work this time again. So guys, and that was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, you know, to keep me strong and motivated to upload new doll repaint videos every week Friday. Please don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. And we will see each other already very soon next week Friday in a new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.